I'm going to share my top 7 mission-critical apps for my iPhone to help me get things done. From power note-taking to calendar management, even to editing podcasts on my iPad or iPhone, the app I use to access my Macs remotely, and I have some honorable mentions at the end, too. Number 1, I use my calendar for everything, not only work events and videos, but also family events and personal items. And Fantastical is simply the best calendar app for the iPhone. Number 1, I love this view. I get a full month view here at the top, and my event list here underneath. And there's a ton of preferences I'll show you in a second. But one of the key features of Fantastical is I can create calendar sets, which means I can have a work mode, a weekend mode, main calendars, and I can adjust what calendars appear depending on the calendar set. And then if I create focus modes on my iPhone, I can actually have specific calendars set as a focus filter. Here down in the settings and focus modes, I can choose Fantastical and choose which calendar set I want Fantastical to go to in this focus mode. And even if you don't use focus modes, you can also control what calendar sets are triggered in certain times of day. For instance, I can go to calendars and lists, and you'll see the different calendar sets here, and I can choose when this calendar set is active, and I can do that for each set. Now you have multiple views as well. You can swipe down, see your entire year view. I can swipe back and forth to go to different days, adding event, big plus button here, and of course it uses natural language. So I can say something like, lunch with Matthew next Wednesday at noon, at First Watch in South Lakeland. I can tap the location right there so it's a part of the event, and you see it's parsed all that information. I can just quickly add that event, or I can tap Show More to see exactly what it put. The exact First Watch restaurant I was intending, titled the event properly, put it in my default calendar, and because it has the address for the next event, the alerts I can program is not only a specific time, like 10 minutes before, but also time to leave. So it will calculate my current location and then proactively send me a notification when I need to go to be on time. Fantastical also has an incredible widget I use here on my home screen. I use this size widget in a widget stack under weather. I still have my month view on the left and today's events here on the right with weather. I can add an event quickly by clicking the plus button, but because we have interactive widgets, I can actually scroll through the different months and see different days and events just by swiping through. I can even tap a specific date in the small widget and it will jump to that day. Number 2, while the built-in Apple Notes app has gotten really good and is an incredible tool, Bear Note is my default note-taking app. I've taken notes in Bear for many years with many different categories, and I just love the flexibility and being able to write a markdown in a Bear Note. If I click the Compose button, you'll see here this is what it looks like to type a Bear Note. You can also choose from many different themes within Bear, so you can choose the colors and format that you like, and you can also change the font size, the font type, and granular controls like line height and width. You don't get these kind of customizations in Apple Notes. If you're not familiar with Markdown, I'll put a link in the description to the syntax, but I can type an asterisk and it creates an automatic bulleted list, I can do 2 hashtags to create a heading, and bold and italicize things eagerly with 1 or 2 asterisks. Then once I have this formatted, one of the powerful features of Bear is I can select that text, go over, and far to the right in the menu is a copy as feature. When I tap copy as, I can choose to copy this text as plain text, rich text, formatted with those bold and italics. I can even copy it as HTML, highlighted parts only, and this one feature makes it extremely flexible. I also use the Bear app on my iPad and Mac, so all my notes sync everywhere. And this flexibility of writing in Markdown, being able to copy it in multiple formats, plus you can have the format toolbar down here if you would like. And if I hit the eye icon up here, I get a word and character count, I get more information about the note, and then I can hit the 3-dot menu. I have all these options, and then I can choose to export this note in so many different formats, including a PDF, and Bear does a nice job of formatting those PDF files directly from a note. Then you can organize notes by using hashtags. So I can create a new category here. I'll just call it Bear. You can see it auto recommends tags that I already have created, but I just want to create a new one called Bear. And then if I go back to my note list and swipe over one more time, you'll see all the different categories I have. Here's Bear, here's Beard FM, and then you can also have nested hashtags. So I can have Beard FM, and then hashtag courses. I've jotted down some ideas if I ever do a HomeKit 101 course. And to create that nested organization, just slash and another word, and you can do that for all of your categories here. You can also hold on a tag, you can edit it, change the name. I can export all the notes within this category in those different formats. And you can also pin notes so they show up at the very top of the main list or any category lists. Also great swipe actions like pinning a note and trashing a note. And Bear supports the 2-finger swipe to select multiple notes like many apps on the iPhone. All right, number 3, and this is probably my number 1 can't live without, but it's Ferrite for iPhone and iPad. Ferrite is the app that I use to edit all of my podcasts. I've edited podcasts in Ferrite for years now. Every episode of Movies on the Side, link down in the description, my movies podcast, I've edited all of those on the iPad. Apple Insider and HomeKit Insider, all the episodes for the past 4 years, edited on iPad, a lot of times iPad mini. And if I launch any new podcasts, those will also be edited with Ferrite on iPad. Editing podcasts with an Apple Pencil and an iPad is just the fastest way for me to edit. I actually have an entire live stream where you can see me edit a podcast live, see how fast it can be. I'll link it above and in the description. But Ferrite on iPhone is also great. I can plug in a USB-C microphone and record right here in the Ferrite app, edit it right here on the iPhone, and export it MP3 or WAV. If you do any kind of audio editing with Apple devices, I highly recommend Ferrite. All right, number four, I do the grocery shopping for my family, and AnyList is the best app for grocery shopping. You see here, you can have multiple lists for different stores. I have Publix, Sprouts, even an Amazon list. And going into a specific list, you can categorize items and also move the categories up and down in the order that you shop with. AnyList also has this awesome feature if you want to order with Instacart or other delivery services. It will actually automatically take the items you have in the list, search Instacart item by item, and then you can add each item to your Instacart cart. And as you add these items to Instacart, finish your order, AnyList will mark all those items as bought. Of course, the key feature is you can share lists with family members or friends, and you can choose who to share each specific list with, color code your list, theme your list, and my wife uses the calendar app for planning. And so any dinners that we're planning will be put right here, and you can attach ingredients to a recipe like white chicken chili, and then when it's time to do the grocery list, add all these items to a list at once or tap the ones you need, and those automatically go to the store and list for me to go shopping. Number five, when it comes to reading news and aggregating RSS feeds, Reader is my go-to app. I love Reader. I have lots of different RSS feeds in here. I can view all my unread, read the article right here in the Reader app. It does a great job of formatting those articles. Plus, I can mark them as unread. I can star ones, save it for later. You can even add YouTube channel RSS feeds so you have the latest videos right here in the Reader app, easy to share. If you want to learn more about using RSS feeds with YouTube channels and even shortcuts, I have a video on that. Check it out above or the links in the description. I just find Reader to be the best way, simple and easy, to read news via RSS. And number six, a lot of times I'm away from my Mac, but I need to do a task that only the Mac is suited for. For that, I use Screens. Screens is a great app. You install the Kinect app on your Mac, and then you can run this app on your iPad or iPhone. You can log into a Mac remotely, use the iPhone as a trackpad, and then manage everything right here. Screens can use SSH tunneling for extra security, and I've used it for years. I can access any of my Macs wherever I am in the world, and I just find it extremely useful. And number seven, an app critical for me getting things done every single day is Shortcuts. If you watch the channel for any amount of time, you know Shortcuts is a huge part of my workflow. I have so many shortcuts that I use for podcast production, home automations, so many device automations, scanning NFC tags. I do so much with Shortcuts. If you want to get into Shortcuts, I have an entire 101 course building some easy shortcuts, or that you could just download in the description, so I'll link that video down below. But I use Shortcuts every single day, and I could not get my work done without it. So let's do some honorable mention apps that I really love, maybe some new apps, and ones that you might find useful as well. One of my favorite new apps for 2023 was CallSheet. It's from developer Casey Liss, and think of it as just a way better IMDb. With CallSheet, you can see movie info, see things like runtime. There's little Easter eggs like tapping the runtime. It'll tell you when this movie will end if you start watching it right now. Pretty cool. You can see things like where you can stream this movie to rent or buy it. Links out to movie trivia on IMDb, parental guidance. And then if you go to an actress or actor settings, you can see their birthday, how old they are, see the movies they've been in here, tap for more info like other trivia and Wikipedia for that actor or actress. And you don't get all that wild cruft that you do with IMDb. Plus you could pin items up to the top of your home screen, search. It's just an incredible application. I'll link that down below. In iOS 17.2, the Journal app has been one of my favorite new apps for saving images, memories, locations. Absolutely love it. I have an entire video on that as well. It's up on the channel. If you're an experienced journal writer or have been using Day One for a long time, this is probably not going to have all the features you would like. Importing entries or exporting from the Journal app is still missing. There's no iPad app or Mac app. But for someone like me who had not journaled before and wanted to get into it, it's a great way to just quickly write things. It pulls from your movies and podcasts and all of that. I've just really enjoyed it. And finally, while it's not an actual app, iCloud Passwords has been crucial to getting things done and managing passwords with family. Also with iOS 17, you've been able to create shared password groups. I've been using those shared password groups with my kids, my spouse, and even for work use cases. Password options like automatically cleaning up those text messages that send you 6-digit codes to log in. iCloud Passwords has come a long way. I still wish there was a dedicated app for it and a little easier to create items that weren't specific passwords for websites. I would love to save other items like my passport number, travel rewards, things like that, but there's no options for those kinds of items. But if you want to learn more about iCloud Passwords and maybe switching from another password app, I have an entire video on that as well, down in the description. And if you have any questions on the third-party apps that I'm using, or would like a deeper dive on something like Bear or Fantastical, let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button before you go. And I'll put a couple videos up here. Might be shortcuts, might be smart home. I'm not sure yet. This one will actually be what YouTube thinks you would enjoy the most. So you should check that out. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.